It's always sad to see aircraft being retired and scrapped, but where do these planes end up when this happens? Today, we'll take a look at aircraft graveyards and highlight some of the largest around the world. Many airlines send aircraft to graveyards for retirement or long-term storage. Despite being called graveyards, they're not just places for aircraft to be forgotten about. When they are truly no longer wanted, aircraft will usually be taken apart and scrapped. While many aircraft end up rusting and decaying in graveyards, others are just temporary residents, just staying until they're needed back in service, or perhaps sold. These aircraft will be maintained and kept ready. Meanwhile, other aircraft will never return to service and instead will be retained for supplying spare parts. There are aircraft graveyards all over the world. Most are located in desert or semi-desert environments. This lack of rain and moisture offers the best conditions for the storage of aircraft, reducing corrosion to the airframe and other components. The desert also offers dry, hard ground that does not need to be paved. And there's plenty of affordable space for storage and expansion. Davis-Monthan, near Tucson, Arizona, is home to the U.S. military's 309th Aerospace Maintenance and Regeneration Group. This is a major graveyard for U.S. government and military aircraft, and it has an impressive collection. Some reports claim there are as many as 4,000 aircraft stored at this site, which can be toured by bus. There are several boneyard sites in the deserts of California and Arizona used for commercial aircraft. Pinnell Air Park in Arizona is one of the largest, with capacity for around 400 aircraft. It's not always clear which airlines store or retire their aircraft where, but Pinnell has been used by many airlines, including Delta, Air Canada, and JetBlue. Like many other graveyards, Roswell was an Air Force base during and after World War II. As well as operating as a small regional airport today, it's home to several storage and recycling companies. Roswell can accommodate up to 800 aircraft. Victorville in Southern California is home to the Southern California Logistics Airport. ComAv operates a graveyard that can accommodate around 500 aircraft. Notably, in the last 2 years, Southwest Airlines has stored many of its Boeing 737 MAX aircraft in Victorville. On the other side of the world, Asia-Pacific Aircraft Storage in Alice Springs, Australia, is one of the largest outside the US and the only one in the Asia-Pacific region. Opened in 2014, this graveyard shares runways with Alice Springs Airport, the largest of which can handle the Boeing 747 and the Airbus A380. Its location makes an excellent choice for Australian and Asian airlines, especially for short-term storage, as it avoids a long trans-Pacific flight to storage in the US. While Europe may not have the extensive deserts of the US or Mexico, there are still some dry and arid climates. Teruel in Spain provides the largest of these facilities. Here you'll find almost 100 aircraft stored, including 8 A380 aircraft at one point in 2020. Additionally, the site houses the whole of Lufthansa's A340-600 fleet. Aircraft graveyards are certainly impressive and haunting sights to see, whether in real life or just in photos. Have you ever visited an aircraft graveyard? Feel free to share your experience in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.